Hello, hello. It's me. Let's fix that. Let's fix that too. Goddamn. What was it like last night for me? Leaving everything in a state I don't remember. Let me change this real quick. Do I need to lower it? I think we're fine for right now. I might need to double check something, but otherwise I think we're good. All right. First order of business, I feel like shit. So I am absolutely dealing with allergies. To the point that they did get me physically ill. So that's tight. Which is part of the reason that I just want to do solo. Because I don't have to worry about fucking up anyone else. Which does bring up the fact that I need to raise my Aether Pool. And stuff like that. So it's why I address the title as Trialing Solo. Because it's not like I can make an actual real attempt. What I do want to do is really try out one, like if it's going to work in general and if it's going to work with me as a warrior. I don't know. Part of me, I don't know. Man, learning that there's a travel point right there, that's huge. I'm just so used to seeing an NPC there with a green name that I didn't think anything of it, considering Ko had moved. But yeah, I want to see if warrior is possible for me. I know something that's really popular is to typically run it as a physical ranged, mostly machinist, or red mage, just because of the burst that you can bring. I am curious about summoner, now knowing that red mage is popular. Summoner has been changed. Maybe? It's all like instant casts. I don't know. I feel like a lot of it at higher floors anyways is knowing the mobs and luck. Because when you're dealing with things like traps, I mean, you can't control that. You can try to do your best and do something about it, but view my scores. Is this anything? What is this? Oh, there we go. Okay. I was looking for the solo rankings. Because this would answer my question on people haven't gotten to that. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. People got to floor 100. I don't doubt that people have. And these are rankings. Does it only show top 25? Looks like it. Yeah, down to hop in, find out. I mean, my party ranking seems low, but that's kind of based on a point system that I don't really fully understand, and I don't know, I feel like most people don't either. God damn. Okay. That is the thing that I mostly have to apologize going into today, is the sneezing and, well, everything related to allergies. I do have tea, that I'm going to be having instead of coffee. So, see how that is. Also, Orthos potions are most likely going to be like the thing that you need. But I don't want to start using my Aether Pool fragments until I get the cosmetic, which does make me a little baby about it, but all right. Let's reset the 31, because our 51 we're keeping with that group. So I would like to progress with them. 31 was the same people we just swapped out. Evo for a red mage instead of a dragoon, and then Swift went Reaper instead of Dancer, because it was just like, you know, just being our best classes. So I'll reset 31 and we'll hop in. Just fixed, because it's just me. Hey, honey, how are you? I'm sure I want to enter alone. I think I want to do it from floor one. I mean, I don't expect to get the achievement, but I do want to double check. I'm pretty sure you have to do, yeah, 1 through 100 in Palace. 1 through 50 solo. That's an achievement. And then 1 through 100 solo. It's once in Future King. Plus, I want to do 1 because I want to get more Aether Pool arm. That's honestly the most important part about this, is seeing whether or not Warrior is going to work for me and Aether Pool arm. So we'll try it out. Which, I'm wondering if I should bring over any, like my character info, should I move it over? If people care to see that, I don't really know. Like knowing what I had. Yeah, I think if I'm running deep dungeon, knowing what I have on me is probably something people care about. Bring it over in a second. Not a ton of damage, I'm gonna tell you that. I don't like how big that is. Just make sure people find it legible. Then again, we also have chat over there too, so we'll try it out. I think my biggest concern with not having burst, or like effective burst, is when we come across the enemies that do things like self-destruct. Like, am I going to be able to beat them fast enough? I don't think so. But they were like room-wide larger than you can get away. I don't really have that freedom of movement either. So I'm going to become a lot more familiar with what the hell these arms do. You know, how many of these have been coming that way? This is the third, fourth succubus we just fought now. At least we can move on. I know my goal mostly is going to be silver chests. I don't expect to succeed. I mean, I'm not going to set myself up for failure, but I don't want to spend too much time on the lower floors without getting to the farther ones to progress and like learn and see what it's like. Because what I would hate to do is to spend, you know, 40 minutes of prep for 5 minutes of stepping on a bomb and dying. Eighth bull arm remains unchanged. Cool. Up and just move on. Alright, so steel lowers damage, which I don't really need on these earlier floors. Probably should have gotten that golden chest for where it looked like we started, but ooh. Alright, where do we want to go? Affluence increases the treasure coppers on the next floor. Could do that. I'm just waiting to see if it turns. Guess not. And want to learn if it does the tail attack. Guess not. Oh, there's a roaming succubus, which I almost felt like I could have gone by. Roaming too? God damn. Definitely need my arm and armor up. Yeah, like, look at that. I guess that's classic tank damage, though. Probably why it's more important for me to rush through, so I don't use up too much time outside of the boss room. We'll see. Wow, that didn't work out at all. You're there on a silver coffer. like wondering if I should have pulled the Dahak over early. Oh fuck, okay. Maybe it was good I didn't, because the claw just spawned over there. I just want that silver chest. It is silver, yeah, okay. All right, what did we get? Sight? Sight, affluence, strength, steel. I don't really know what floors I want to start using sight on. In turn. Now, can I walk by you? I feel like I. Oh, well. I was gonna say, I feel like I can't. Which maybe we'll find out. Nope. Okay. Wonder how much of a difference Primal Wren's gonna be. Damage wise, not too different, but God, do I want every little bit. This is probably way too hot, so. Ish. It's alright. But we have Blood Wedding now. Alright, steel. The grenade is the one that explodes up close, right? And then you have to, like, get out of the way. Because I don't think you can interrupt it. I don't remember anything like that. Oh, no wonder everything feels off. I'm sped up right now. I have haste. Let's find out. Big burst. I'm gonna fuck off. You don't die from it. But we do have a succubus coming. Yeah. Don't really have anywhere to go with this. I just don't want to fight both of them at the same time. Which I guess we are. Alright, big burst. Does it hurt the succubus? No. That'd be a pipe dream. I think we touched like three fucking silver chests so far too, and none of our aether pool change. I understand it's because we're on like floor three, but goddamn. What do we have in that room? Ooh, there's a silver in here. I'm gonna keep trying for it. I think this is gonna be the last silver I try for on 1 of 10. Because after that, I probably don't actually get anything 1 of 10. Like, I know when you're at a lower level, you don't get your aether pool raised. I just don't remember at which level it becomes effective again for me. It's Someone gave you a bag of high chews and you can't stop eating them? Oh god. I know an easy way to stop eating them. Fucking look at the back. Dude, the info on those motherfuckers. They're delicious though, so I don't blame you. I'm 370 calories for the whole bag? You're serious? The whole bag is that much? Or that little, I should phrase it that way. The fuck? I see a golden chest over there. Our damage is low as fuck, though. Yeah, it's honestly not that much. Just want to move on. I guess now that I'm thinking about it, I mean, we're getting practice. We're figuring out, like, what floor I start struggling with. Okay, yeah. But I guess I could have just started 21. I kind of completely forgot that I was too high for... How do I even phrase this? Aether pool changes? Oh my fucking god. They just spawned too. Not like I stepped on anything. Yeah, I'll be real though. 370 calories for the whole bag is really surprising. Because it's like a standard gummy bear size bag, I think. 370 for the whole thing. Oh, part of me doesn't believe that. I'm just assuming so because of the amount of sugars in it. Unchanged, okay. Intuition reveals current floor's treasure. Ooh. Somebody's gonna be roaming. We know that for certain. Commander of Flight. He's gonna turn soon. Lethargy. Woo! There's the turn. This is where I have to go though, so I'm okay with fighting this guy. Just keeping an eye out if anyone comes that way. I think it's just the demon and the other Dahawk. Grenade big burst is the one I gotta move out for, yeah. All right, I'm close enough to opening it. My God. What stops me from fighting all of them? Since I pulled them all at separate times, I believe they are all gonna do the look separately. Do I just not remember other deep dungeons that well? I feel like they don't ever randomly spawn as many enemies as this one does. I mean, it wasn't really like a solo deep dungeoner for the others, but goddamn. I've never spent this much time fighting on the low 1 to 10 levels. They definitely spawn more in this one. Okay. Makes me feel better about being, I don't know, off put by it. What? Yeah, like this guy. He was not there before. Like, this is a literal dead end. How much faster would I be fighting them if I was, say, ranged? I mean, probably a lot, but I'm also wondering how much damage I would end up taking, too. Oh no. Gloom, huh? Enemy movement speed increased. Enemies also deal more damage while taking less. Fucking awesome. Witching. Thankfully, I'm not in combat, so I had 20 seconds. Okay. All right, whatever. It's a lot of grenades on this level. It's also disappointing that they're not self-destruct hurting themselves. Okay, you can stun them. There's a lot of enemies you can't stun though, so definitely don't want to make it a standard expectation. I don't think I'm that close to opening it, but We'll see. Yeah, actually, no, of course it wouldn't be, because it's not even orange. I probably have to fight more than these grenades. If I leave that late, we're good. Okay. So I don't need to be on high alert. As long as I treat it like a standard get out attack, then we're fine. Other people, I gotta be high alert, but. Yeah, I definitely should have skipped ahead to floor 21 because I'm real curious about them fucking little robot guys that do the cannon and then they self-destruct. Let me move my tea. I think I might want it on this side. I don't really know. As long as I'm doing, not doing buffs, I don't really need my my right hand. Also, fucking. Wow. So I do need this guy. That's so cool for me. There we go. We're fine. Yeah, see, they're a fully resisted stun kind of person. Wait, what? That wasn't enough? Remember, typically when they're orange, they're a hit away. I'm locked, okay. Finally. So also just rushing through the center as I expect him to blow up. All right, safety. Chest, huh? We got boogs or whatever the fuck they are. Boot. That's what it is. Gold chest for either. Silver, and I'm sure floor 6 doesn't count. Alright, so I gotta go this way anyways, ahead of me. Turn right. So you're looking straight at it. Let me find out if walking is fine for you. Yeah, I didn't think so. Further in, but close enough to be getting both of them to hate me. I just don't want to add the other water sprite onto my agenda. And Vasco spawns in. Nightmarish. Yeah, I know I have 30 minutes left. These motherfuckers keep spawning. Warren, is that a get out? Okay. The knockback. I assume it snapshotted early, so its damage shouldn't really change based on distance. Also, another one. Meteor, which means I need to kill you in that amount of time. Super cool. Love that. It's Santa plus. Okay, damage minimal. So it is purely just a knockback. Ooh, I don't have enough for this. Break line of sight. This is part. That really hard to tell if it was gonna kill me, but it felt like it was going to. Like when I saw it land, I thought I was still within the range. Hey. Oh, cool. Another water sprite. That's tight. Love that for me. Get up here. I prefer not to fight the behemoth as well. Should be enough. Unless you're gonna do this yellow to mid orange. There you go. Three floors. Level 5 Petrify on the Sentry. Let's figure this sprite would move. Alright, level 5 Petrify is a look away, but it's only a cone in front of him. Dread Gaze, now that's... That is level 5 Petrify, okay. Wasn't 1000% sure, even though I just said it. I could not recall its actual name, so it freaked me the fuck out. Kill you. What do we got? Water sprites. They're easy to be found. And another one just spawned way up there. Alright. We're not really ready to fight a behemoth, but 20 seconds we are. Wait, did I drop my combo? Is it actually 30 seconds already? That's crazy. Alright, we'll have to fight the water sprite slow, because I want to keep all of my bursts for Behemoth. Yeah, this should be easy. And now it's on orange. Orange to yellow. Three enemies in here with a gold chest. That's fine. You can see me from there. Whatever. I wanted it to be a corner so bad. You know, I wonder if I can survive its meteor by shielding. Home gang, I could. Actually, I might have to get my own answer. Woo! Alright, we killed him in time. Affluent, chest on the next floor. There we go. Intuition. Which one's intuition? Wait, terror touch. Interrupt that. Reveals the current floor's hidden treasure. Oh, so there is a treasure here, huh? Yeah, I don't know for sure whether or not Meteor is a guaranteed one-hit kill, or just does a lot. Okay. Safety. Yeah, we need to move on to the next floor, like, immediately. Intuition. Let's do this. Let's pop this one. Pop the deal. I have a feeling they're gonna do the AoE that you're supposed to interject. And I'll only be able to interject one, but we'll find out. If so, that's my hubris and my fault. Orange Justice is fine if they keep with. Because he can stun that. Oh, excuse me. Oh, great, this asshole's here. Cool. I'm loving this. Making me feel more and more like a higher chance of doing the old deep dungeons, which is a very weird feeling because I like fighting with my level 90 rotation. That's why I'm surprised you didn't do 21 to 30. Straight up, I forgot that silver chests don't affect you at low levels because I don't like touch this kind of content at all. Oh my fucking god, more of them? Yeah, I just straight up forgot. Like, my whole reasoning was let me go to a low level because I need to raise my aether pool. That was it. Good to know. I'm just the dragon's awake. I was hoping it was gonna be like the sleeping ones in the dungeons or you can walk by them. Dangerous as fuck fighting in the middle, but hey. It's got a few more people until it's done. Oh, I did not interrupt in time. Movement speed and HP recovered via healing magic reduce. Wait, that's it? I mean, I'm sure at like later levels that'd be very important, but right now it's not that impactful to me. I'm not pylon. Alright, boss time. Alright, boy. Let's do this. Little Mandragora. I don't need to use anything, I'm fine. I guess food. Maybe not. So I gotta be on this inside here if they're straight. I know I can be right here if they're diagonal from me. Yeah, like right here. This should be good. Oh, even more inside. Alright. Thought I figured out the distance and then it went longer than the other one. Maybe when they do that version of their explosion, it's wider. I don't know. I'm also probably just bullshitting myself. And I'm mad because bad. Yeah, definitely one of the reasons I want to run as a tank is due to the fact that I don't have a lot of those Orthos potions, and you can see how important they are. Did I have equilibrium on cooldown? Really? Crazy. Yeah, 10 minutes to fight this guy. Jesus. Ooh. Maybe I do pop a strength. I'm so lucky this was 3. Because I wasn't moving. With how late that was, passing through would have just guaranteed I got hit. Oh man, you want to do another ability and, you know, keep it fresh, I'm down. Cool. Freeze over here. Wow, it's such a long fight. I should know this though, when we fought the Chimera last time. That one took a while. More with 7 minutes left. It would have been tight, I think, if I had not used strength. Like, I don't think impossible, but just tight. Let me zoom through the next 10. There we go. No more poetics. Next floor. definitely know for next time.
Oh, okay.
This floor counts for increasing my strength. So maybe it wasn't that bad. Alteration. I don't remember what this guy does. Remember in most deep dungeons to fear him on later levels. I think it was Heaven on High. Maybe not. Doesn't seem to be doing anything else. Got a witching and a move on. Wait. That's where we have to go. So I need to fight these guys anyways. Spirulinas don't seem to do anything. They're just normal enemies. I'm trying to recall back on Thursday of us doing it and what we learned, but it has been a minute. Takes so long to kill them. Alright, Morbal is hopefully stunnable. Shouldn't be in a bad position with it because Bad Breath is relatively easy to dodge. Kind of waiting for it to do it again. There we go. And there's the sun. Cool. It works. Oh, but we are not ready to go. You the one with the swipe? Giant one? Remember fighting a big version of you in Criterion. It's just normal. Same modeled enemy as the one in the further maps that does the exact same thing, the swinge attack or whatever it was. Oh fuck. I want that silver so bad. Why can't I just AoE everybody? This is a Bad Breath. Okay, now we have them at separate times. Yeah, now we're good. Don't pull them at the exact same time, because you don't want them to overlap Bad Breaths, because they don't often do it in the same spot. Oh, amen. Oh, banded coffer. How cute. Look at that. I could just be more open to AoE pulling, but I know how bad that is. You wild for opening that chest while being hit? I knew it wouldn't kill me. Like, missing only 15% HP, it would not have killed me. That's the only thing that I was like, I'm good for doing that, because I had a blood wedding. As long as I'm 10 HP, I can heal. The repercussions? Repercuss this. Yeah, nah, I was good. Like, watch, we'll try with this one. Get hit. Hit me twice, come on. Yeah, lethargy, okay. Like, if it exploded, I just know how much a chest does to me. But hey, I mean, it still happened to us. I hit a landmine while fighting. I don't know if you've noticed that part. That exact same pool, we hit a landmine. We have a Keter. Cool. Now we can take this fight into the hallway. That's easier. What do I have? No auto healing? Okay. Do I hear footsteps? Yup. Yes, I do. This is more how I'm used to fighting. It's probably what I should have been doing instead of pulling them one by one. Like, this was faster, right? Not even enough to leave. No auto heal, right? Intuition. What does intuition do again? Yeah, I already found the accursed door, didn't I? No, that was last map. Oh yeah, it's way easier. And finding him in the hallway, I don't have to worry about anything. Other than more enemies just walking in and existing. Because they are want to do that. Okay, this is where I'm at my weakest is right now. So I don't have any way of healing for a bit. I have it now, but... We'll just wait for equilibrium to have more return by letting its dot do its work. And done. Awesome. Remains unchanged. Fuck you. Maybe next time I fight a large group like that, I remove all the traps from the floor. That's insane. 3,500 bitrate, and I'm still gray again. I don't trust the micro system because I don't remember what it does, so I'm not going to fight it with everything else here. Unless it becomes out of my control. Of course. Down. Another one spawns. Stun fully resisted, really? I don't need to do my AoE rotation no more. Silver. Cool, both unchanged. Awesome. Innervation. Of course I had a trap there. Alright, let's see. Phoenix down. Yeah, see? Only did 34k. Probably now, like, what, 35%? Some of that? Let's see what the micro system has. Now it's with innervation still active too. Yeah, it doesn't look like the microsystem does anything like super important. About this wood golem. already feel like I've spent too much time on these floors. Maybe I haven't. We're at 14. We have 44 minutes. I don't remember what the timer started with. That's something that matters a lot, actually. What does a Belladonna do again? Let's activate a strength. We already have damage down. Okay. Let's gather everybody up. I don't really remember what Belladonna does, but it doesn't really matter. Oh, fuck. I got turned into an owl. Well, if I explode, I'm dead now. That's why I did damage up. I wanted to be able to possibly take them down in time. Yeah, what, 15 seconds left on them being a animal? Might not be able to kill. I don't do a lot of damage, but I'm getting pretty low. And a little bit of reprieve. There we go. All right, back to normal. Now they're gonna die. It's time, baby. Oh. Right, let me get the silver too. Ooh, plenty of them as well. Which, no, none of them drop stuff after I killed them, which was annoying. All that unchanged. Cool. Manatee. That's awesome. Strength, another one is always welcome. Was this anti-knockback? What's the one that turns you into a manticore anyways? Damn it. Oh, so close. Unchanged, unchanged, unchanged. This is the guy that pulls you in, right? Wait, what? Wait, what did I just die to? It was in like 1 second. I didn't get hit by his head spin, did I? Yeah, of course I have battle text off. Huh. Weird. Entry point, this really allowed me to just go through again? I thought I failed. Oh well, let's reset that anyways, because now that I know I don't really have to start from one. Or at least I don't get any bonuses from doing it right now. That's fine. Alright, enter, fixed, and 21. Yeah, what did I die from? I didn't think I was in his head spin, but that's the only thing I can think of that did that much damage. Because I didn't hear an explosion, plus I believe I had defenses up too. Yeah. Let's find out about this Demolisher real quick. This, more than anything, is going to let me know on whether or not I can continue. Or if I need to get my Aether pull up. I wonder if I should stay in it and try and like buff up and everything and find out if I can live. I'd imagine not. Yeah, see, that's way too big. You have to kill it. That took my entire burst, so I'm not allowed to pull one until I have all of my burst. That's kind of rough. Like, there was no breathing room for that. So long. Ortho Demolisher. I don't have two things of someone infuriate. The Demander is sight. Poison, really. Look away, guys, are kind of annoying to fight in a group. Tail, I just wanted to get rid of this guy so I don't have to deal with the poison as much. So everything else is pretty much just being patient, right? At least it feels that way. Absolutely no reason to risk that one fell cleave on it. Wasn't worth it at all. I could have just waited. just want to fucking interact with this goddamn chest. Everybody just keeps spawning behind me. Here we go, finally. I've raised something about my Aether Pool. Stun the shit out of him and walk away. God, I wish I could. I wish I could just stun him and walk through the exit. Yeah, alright. 421, huh? Yeah. I gotta review that the footage to find out. It had to have been Headspin that hit me. Add speed to my movement? Oh, really? I just have infinite sprint right now? Well, I don't want to accidentally click it off because it is nice. But that's cool. Finding all these ones would suck. Is there anything that way? No. Crazy that he casts Spike Tail and then still has to touch me physically in order for it to work. So I just noticed he like kind of held on to that ability and then still came up on me. Come on. We can do more damage. Willing and open. I gotta find out like a good food for in here. Cause I assume, based on how it scales stats, that I probably don't get a bonus from bringing my current rate tier food. I probably have to bring something lower. Maybe like a last expansion or even start of expansion. I'm not really sure. I don't know how much it wants to perform like actual Eureka or Boja or any of that. Oh. Is that somebody roaming? No, it's just a dragon back there. Come on. You know, I'm really curious, time-wise, like for that given enemy, if I had the Aether Pool arm I do now at 42 versus 99, like legitimately how much faster would it be? Are we talking 3 seconds or like 15 seconds? I'm just curious. Ortho Knights. I don't really want to fight two of them at once. I can fight the giant, that's fine. Because we want to get out, right? Ooh. It's even bigger. Even bigger than I thought. I don't remember if I can stun this guy. We're going to find out because he's going to use it again soon. No, I cannot. Oh, and that's so big. Sorry? What am I clicked on? Why would you target that? I did my gap closer. There's a motherfucker right in front of me. What would be the best class for me to bring? I feel like melee makes it a little hard. Like if I was to do a melee DPS, I'm not talking tank wise, but just like melee in general. Because tank is melee, but it has the benefit of being tanky and able to heal myself more often than most moves, so. I was wondering why that guy didn't see me, but I felt like if I mentioned it, then he would see me. Electromagnetism. Oh, fuck. Got innervated. Happy right? Innervated? Innervation. Thank God. I just didn't want to do it into the other guy's body slam. It's so long. It's so long to fight these guys. Lethargy strength. I might fucking pop their goddamn strength. Just keep it always active. 7 minutes, though. Will I have it at the boss? That's the question. That's when you really need it. Oh, well, we'll find out. Fight two of these guys at once. I don't really want to like bring them in. Ooh. That headspin did a lot because I went in too soon. But still didn't do as much as we would have had to do to kill me last time. So I don't know. No. They won't even let me fight them. You summoned a little piece of shit. Yeah, please move on. Unless I need you, which I probably do. Yep, I do. It's like me and him are the same level right now. We're both 90. Doesn't even feel it. How many more do I need to fight? It's that orange, so either one or two. Oh, there's the two. God, fucking three minutes already have been spent on the same floor. The return glows, but not the continuation. Oh, fuck. Forgot mimics existed. Alright, let's interrupt infatuation. Death trap we can stay outside of. So I need my stun in my pocket. In case they innervate again. Do they actually time it out so it's in between interruption casts? If so, that is very generous. I just want to leave. Get me out of here. I'm not seeing enough silver chests. Yeah, I'm trying to remember how the save file stuff works. Like, if I was to go with a bunch of randoms, say I join with them for 21 to 30, and then that same group obviously doesn't want to continue. I think if I say match party in the save file, I can just keep going up on the floors as long as I'm queuing in with people. I think that's how it works. Like if I wanted to try and get higher levels with randoms, I think you can do that. I'm considering methods in which I might need Aetherpool faster than Solo can get me. Holy shit, was I not out of that? That's fucking crazy. So armor is 38 and arm is 42. Nope. Oh, really? It's only for set parties? I thought I had done that before and won't let you do it with matched. Really, you just can't continue with matched. So interesting. So the only method of really doing it is just repeating 21 to 30. Which, this is probably my least favorite tile set, too. But I've said enough about that. Just fighting the one. Bloom and can't use items and no passive HP regen. Now I have to wait. There you go. Because I went back in too early last time and took a lot of damage. Other ones let you, but this one is weird. Okay, so I'm not crazy for thinking that I have done it. It's just that this one specifically won't let me do that. Okay. That makes me feel better, I guess. Where's my phone? Fuck, where is my phone? I forgot that I needed to push some like Warframe crafting stuff. I have no idea where my phone is. Yeah, grinding out for Aetherpool might be the strat for me before progressing harder. And figuring out if Warrior for sure is the class I want to do. I mean, that's what I'm doing right now, is figuring it out, but... Right, I can't bring up actual character info. Just gonna take a look at the classes again and just be like, oh man, which one would be better for me? What does Summoner perform? Like, I know I mentioned earlier, but it's got Burst. It's kind of like a ranged. You have your personal shield. You don't have a heal. You don't have an interrupt. You don't have a stun. Kind of sounds like it sucks. I mean, it's doable, I'm sure. Just like the idea of them having their movement. Because I just don't enjoy playing new machinists that much. Dancer doesn't do that much damage. Bard, I'm not really sure about. I just don't know. Love it in PvP, but could not tell you how it performs here. Alright, that's the Swinge Dragon. It's the Return Pylon. What about leaving? In the center of this room. Ortho Blue. Clear. Yeah, like going through all this and they're still at like 50% HP. The other dragon. Hopefully he turns the fuck around immediately. Since that's how bright it is outside, even though I have it covered. All right, cool, my arm went up one. Wait, I'm unable to use abilities. This sucks. I have nothing useful to use right here. This is get away. But also lethargy, so it's really hard to time out when to get away. See that bird echoing in the background. I didn't see any of the other ones do it before. Of course, fucking low blow is an ability. This. Oh yeah, can't use abilities, includes my heal, huh? That sucks. I guess my only heal then is off of Storm's Path. Do I have anything that gives me back my ability to use abilities, remove all enhancements, enchantments, which includes bad or good? Oh, I died anyways. Okay, because I was just reading that and Venara got pulled. That's fine. This will not count towards solo completion achievements. All right, there's where it specified it. God, I am fucking washed the fuck out though. I feel like shit. Set progress. What do we got? I mean, tanks are fine. They're cool. They just take a while. I'm not good enough for right now. Summoner is what we had considered. Machinist is always solid for burst. Monk, maybe? I don't know. It's just, yet again, I still don't have a lot of the potions. And that's the biggest thing. I don't have all these guys. Let's see. Damn, is there really no background music going on here? I think I might just try to raise my Aether Pool arms and do that in public. Like I said, I'm just trialing it. I think it takes way too much time and focus too. I mean, I am still sick. I don't fucking feel well at all. We'll see how that goes. What could I come as? Could try the summoner bit, see how that feels. Enter with a matched party. Let's do 21. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see how well this is working out. What did we pick up? Intuition. Yeah, because I still have a cast time. We're in 3. We can go into things like Bahamut. And immediately I can fight like this. I'm trying to pay attention to just the damage I'm doing. See the scale different. Yeah, a little bit hard to tell considering there's 4 people, but I am noticing when it chunks when I decide to do something. Fire ran out. That's what happened. It's like, what the fuck, dude? A little bit of damage. Okay. So it's faster. I guess you could call it considerably faster. Yeah. Be honest though, we'll have to see how much longer I can go because I can feel my sickness catching up with me. I didn't know how well I would do today, but I kind of just wanted to still try because I'd rather stream than not. I like it. Oof. What's that one? Purity? Reduce pox. Okay. It is funny just how insane it is when you have four people and the goon squad it. A stark comparison. Wait, Ruby Wright just missed. Oh, we have lowered accuracy.
Okay.
I didn't see that as our thing for a second. I was like, what the fuck do you mean my main attack missed? Sitch activated, okay. Trying to keep up on fighting all of them is funny. Yeah, let's see. I have my personal shield. That's all you would pretty much be bringing into this content solo. No interrupt. No heal. Well, I'm sure somebody considers Phoenix a heal, but it's not as on demand as, say, Blood Wedding or Equilibrium. Oh man. Yep, there it is. There it is, actively catching up with me. I thought I got hit by that, honestly. I had just straight up assumed it snapshotted me. Yeah, already 25. don't know why I put it there when I knew that they would walk in. Oh. Such a terrible idea. Pay attention to which way the one of them was aiming. More of these fucking dragons. Wait, why the hell did only I get hit by my buff? I mean, I knew I was out of range for one of them, but... these tiles on the ground. Yeah, I think this run might actually be the last one. I've gotten to the point now where I'm just struggling to stay awake. So my body wants to shut down and go back to bed. And I think given that I'm sick, I need to let it. Sorry. Because this one's a spell, no one's an ability, and I can't use abilities. Oh, it's so fucking cheeky, I swear. Why does my bitrate mark me as offline? The hell? I can't do anything at all. Oh, I can auto attack. I guess I can do that. Still labeled as offline for bitrate. OBS doesn't say that though, that's what's weird. can we get away with this? I actually thought that we could have just killed the Diamondback user in general. Didn't even interrupt him. Yeah, now it's connected. So weird. Actually, pretty sure I keep changing this to be flipped the other way on that reason, and someone else keeps moving it. Oh, I see, they're pacified. Healer is. I'm not able to use my fucking Radiant Agents because my Carbuncle is dead. Well, I mean, dead in quotation marks. His Ifrit was out and wouldn't go the fuck away. It's rough. Neat. At least if they activate the passage, we can move on. And then we have the boss. Oh, there we go. I saw that interaction. Cool, cool, cool. Doo-doo. Oh, as soon as I do that, the music changes. Right, it is boss time. Tiamat. All right, Twisters. Yeah, I guess it makes sense they go right into it. Yeah, how do they not have technical finish? Yeah, they just did it. Wormtail, right. I didn't even read it. Not a tank. I don't have an excuse. Whew. I'm not in it, right? Yeah, okay. Then you're gonna do Worm Wing. Really, way more in first? Oh, that's the name of the cast move that actually has it go out after the person, right? Eh, at least you're finished. That's fine. That's easy. Oh, but doing that raises my arm and armor a lot. Okay, so I can just do 21 to 30 over and over again until I raise it up. That makes more sense. The only thing that sucks is that I don't think I get... No, I do get an Aether Pool Fragment. Okay. That's easy. That is a more achievable and doable goal. And it might honestly be what I do with others, say, Thursday. Because as unfortunate as it sounds, I mean, I feel like I sound like it. No, I'm off, but I'm still sick. I thought I'd be maybe fine enough to stream, but no. No, I'm not. I need to end it, go back to bed, rest up, or something the fuck. All I know is I did have fun trying it out. And I will be on Thursday. As long as I'm not sick. If I am, let you know on Twitter and the Discord. If I'm not, see you then. But otherwise, I'm out. Y'all take care.